Madume thobela ke a dumedisa leina ke le lebotse leina ke la morena Jesu ke re e sa le kgoši le mamotlhale o santšane a rena ka gare ga bophelo bjaka ke a dumela gore wa rena le ka gare ga bophelo bja gago batamela o be kgausi gobane ditaba tsona di dula di le gona ka gare go mogadi channel le mamotlhale re santšana re tlo thea tsebe re santšana re tlo dikwa mme re tlo ithuta le gona go bulega mahlo ka mehla ditaba di dula di le gona moporofeta ga a šalele morago gobane ge e le revelation yona e tswela pele ge e le modimo yena ga se a eme gomme ditaba tsa gagwe o ntse a di fetiša ka baporofeta ba gagwe mme tsukiswa o gona le lekgono o tlo bolela ka taba e kgolo batamela o be kgausi gobane ye ke revelation o tlhoka go e kwa o bolela ka army of God o bolela ka sesole sa modimo gore na go diragalang ka sesole se re se kwa se bolelwa ka kua go revelation gomme re a tlhatholelwa ka sona gore na sesole seo se eme ka mohuta mang gona se tlo bereka jwang ge go diragetse eng batamela o be kgausi gobane ka nnete re tloga re ithuta ka gare mogadi channel ke ona tabakgolo ke ona morerokgolo ona o o rena le wena re ithute mme matlho ona a tsebe go bulega ge e le gore o moyeng wa dikwadi ya fisha o seka ya go lena ba maoto gobane wa amogelegile gomme ikwele o le ka gae o ka ba leloko le feleletseng ka go subscribe gore le wena ga ditaba tse di tsena di seke tsa go feta di fitlhele go wena two notification o ihumane e le gona di fetsa go latlhelwa gomme re ntse re lebogela le maikutlo a lena ka comment section re a leboga le wena o ntseng o supporta lenaneo le re re malebu a re batamele a re dikwe ge moporofeta a di rarolola goba a di beya tafoleng a diala ka molomo wa gagwe wa go ja bogobe thea tsebe
Hello everyone, I hope you're well. My name is Zukiswa and I am a prophet. I am the prophet before God. Yeah, a servant of the Lord Jesus Christ, born again, baptized, Holy Spirit filled and commissioned in 2023 February to be the voice or the prophetic voice of God to the black and brown communities in the world. That is the Africans and Indian nationals with their descendants, wherever they may be in the world. I hope you're well. Today I am releasing a video that is the word of the Lord that is very uncomfortable for me, but I must do it because the Lord says all righteousness must be fulfilled, basically. It is one of the most intimate conversation I had with God after some revelations about the 144, the lampstands, the two olive trees, basically about Zechariah 4, where Zechariah wakes up and the angel of God wakes him up and he sees the golden bowl, and he sees the lampstand on both sides, and then he sees the seven lampstands that are linked to these bowls and stuff like that. And then the angel interprets it for him because he does not understand what is going on. And the interpretation of that dream is the one that is in Revelation 11, talking about two witnesses. So on the 19th of July, the Lord, I kept seeing a man with a head wrap, that Egyptian head wrap that they used to do back in the day in the Bible times. I had kept seeing that man, and there was a knowing in me that it was Joseph. So it was like for 3 days I kept seeing this man. It's like he was just rising up from his seat and he kept walking. He was rising up from his seat and he kept walking. So I asked the Lord and I said, Lord, is that Joseph? And then maybe after 3 days later, I kept seeing this because the Lord would do this thing to me where he would show me an open vision of something and not saying, tell me anything. He'll show me a dream. He'll give me a certain knowing that I can't shake, but not explain it kind of thing. So even in this occasion too, the Lord did the same thing. He kept showing me this man. I kept seeing this man getting up from his seat and just going. I always had to see him getting up from his seat and going. So I then asked the Lord and said, Lord, is that Joseph? I think y'all should go to the Master's Voice blog and find the prayer call that says the beast system is here, part one. there. I only find that out after, by the way of the Spirit, I only find that out after this conversation with the Lord, right? And it makes things very clear. The Lord says Joseph has risen. My army will be established in both houses, Ham and Shem. For all those of you who don't know, if you're a black and a brown person from Latin America, black Asian people, or mixed Yemenis, stuff like that, right until all the Africans and Indian nationals, or from Middle East, origin from the Middle East to the South, and then from all of Africa, those are the two houses of God, the two sons of God, Ham and Shem. And you make either one of them as a black man or a brown person. So the Lord, Ham and Shem in tribes, in all four corners of the world, you will be the captain and you will lead them. It will be with you. Have I not said it? I have raised and purposed you for this work. Only you will I speak to about all matters concerning my people on both houses. You will rank and file my people according to the tribes and their required duties. Guys, after this thing about Joseph as well, there was always this thing about rank and file. I would always hear this voice. There will be a knowing in me that is pressed upon me that this is the angel of the Lord that says rank and file. And I would follow this angel of the Lord. There was the Lord before, then there's the angel behind the Lord, and then it would be me. I'd be following the Lord around, and I would go to these high buildings. That thing is not made out of white steel. I don't know what that material is, but it looks so durable. It's not marble, yet it's not steel. It's like some form of glass, but steel. I'm not sure. But it looks so crystal, whatever, and so solid. So the Lord will open those drawers, and the angels will open those drawers for me. And all I would hear was the ranks and files. And they're still having... explain that one to me. I'm still waiting. But then the Lord will link and make me have this understanding that this is about me releasing the tribes. If I'm telling you that you are this tribe and you belong to this house, that is something you should write it down and keep it. And if I'm telling you this is a meditation for this house, you keep that meditation with you. You write it and you keep it. And it because it becomes your rank and your file. Amen. I am the bowl of gold, and you and celestial are the two lampstands or olives. If you want to understand more about the two lampstands and the two olive trees, go to Zechariah 4 and go to Revelations 11. I think from verse 4 or from verse 3, where it talks about I will empower my two witnesses. Amen. I don't know what's going on with the filter today. I've never been so white. Lord, help me. I can't even recognize myself. I can't change this filter. But we're going to continue. The work of the Lord must be done. I have given both of you the wisdom it will require to lead my people. But, and I said, but Lord, I am a woman. Is this not, and then the Lord says, is this not the time of the Holy Spirit? Yes, Lord, it is, I said. And then the Lord says, I was very shaken, guys. I've never been so shaken. I can't explain that moment when I felt like I am under task and incapable and disabled all at the same time. Like I can never complete this task. Then the Lord says, did not Deborah lead my armies to war and subdued by my might? You will go forth and no one will be able to stand before you, and anybody I dispossess before you, that you will possess. I am in you and you are in me. So I said, is the Lord talking about the 144 army And then the Lord says, the whole army of both houses of my people, Ham and Shem, you will lead, save, and protect. And after, I was very shaken, guys. That's when the Lord told me that I am the captain of his people on earth. This is the age where the people who will go to war with Satan this time will be women. That's when I began to see. After this conversation, I went to sleep. Whenever the Lord does this thing of shaking me to the core, I usually fall asleep. I usually take myself to sleep and tell the Lord I am going to sleep. Because I feel like there, the Lord, that's when I'm able to process my thoughts thoroughly, and then the Lord helps me through it. So after this, in that afternoon, on the 19th of July, I began seeing the most beautiful army I have never seen, on horses of all colors, be it reddish, be it whitish, be it brown, or all shades. These were the women who were black Americans with their heads and their, with, you could see their bonnets. These, there were Native American women there with their adorned horses and their, that necklace they put on and that thing, the head wraps. The Zulu women were there, the Swati women were there, then Rebele women. It was in all, and I saw the Shangans with their tutu thingies there. Guys, it was the most beautiful army I've never seen. And I'm here to tell you, women, the army that is going to war this time is the army of wisdom. The Lord said, the strength.
O tloga o mokwile mo profeta o tloga a di adile o tloga a di beile ka motsela yo a di beileng ka yona mme ke a tshepa gore o gare wa ithuta gona le selong gore wa setopa ka re ga lena neo leng nka thabela seo a re boele re kopana gape lena neo le latelang go bane tsona e saletse dintsi o seke wa ba wa shuta wa ya kgole o dule bona mo gausimo go bane nako e nngwe le nngwe o tla dula o kwa ditaba tsa go tshwana le tsona tse e leng gore nna le wena re tlo golega mme le matlholona a tlo bulega ke re šhala ga botse.